In this video, I will discuss how to install and use Google Classroom effectively. First of all, you have to install Google Classroom from App Store or Apple Store. Whatever you want, you can install Google Classroom. In this way, you can easily install Google Classroom from App Store or Apple Store. Whatever your device, if it is Windows, Mac, whatever laptop or desktop or mobile phone or tab. In this way, easily it can install in your specific device. The installation process will depend on your service provider, internet service provider. If it is slower, time will take in not more than 5 to 10 minutes, because it is not a longer file. There is only 161 megabyte size. I can show you with the moving of the photo. 161 megabyte. It will be installed within 1 to 2 minutes. There are many more languages you can everything installed or stored in Bangla language or English language or any other language. There are 64 more languages except English. So there are 69 languages you can install or use this classroom. It is very easier or effective for the students in this situation, COVID-19. With the help of these apps, you can easily transport, easily install, or easily you can receive, or you can easily send the specific assignment, specific answer to your teacher. You can receive everything from your teacher with the help of these facilities. So my program or apps installed in my device. Now I am trying to start. Now here is written get started. First of all, I just tap on get started. With the help of our device, with the help of a Google account or any other account, we can install this device, we can install these activities, such as I just write an account. I am trying to install with the help of a new account, because of if I give any old account, it will be mixed with the others. for this reason, while trying to explain a new account, for this reason I just write Zoology ISC EV at gmail.com. In this way you can prepare a Google account. With the help of this Google account you can install these activities, then you can give your Google account password and in this way your program will be ready to use. And a Google account and Google Classroom start in your device. Classroom helps to communicate with the teachers very easily. Just Classroom, would you like to send you notification? You just write allow. You should give the tick mark on allow because tick mark is very important. Notification is very important because with the help of notification you can receive all the important activities. There is a plus sign at the lower corner of the box. You just click this button. You can see two things. One of them is join class, another one is create class. If you are a student, you just join class. We just join class, not necessary to create class, because you can create class if you are a teacher, or you can organize with the help of this software, this application. If you are a student, you just click the button or the word join class. I just push the button join class. In this way, you have to need a password or class code. Just written here, class code. You have to write whatever you want, you can write, but you have to be installed a class code of your selected teacher. Given class code because this class code provided with the help of your teacher, specific teacher. I just write a specific class code for trial. I just write a class code for joining a class, and then at the top of the right corner you just see there is written join. You just click on the button join, and then you can easily class not found on this code. You just follow your code is correct or incorrect. I just write the incorrect password for this reason. Now I trying to join the class. I think now I can join the class very easily because now the code was perfect or correct. Now I enter in a class very easily. You can see a class. In this class, teacher provide you a new assignment such as model test 1. A new assignment, model test 1, if it is model test 1 or assignment 1, whatever. Any one of the homework you can provide you, teacher provide you to complete these activities with the help of this. Now I will see what is the model test 1. First of all, I click the model test 1 or assignment 1. There is a PDF format. I just trying to open this PDF format with the help of me. There is a model test question. On the basis of this question, you just start to write answer on your answer script and complete your answer script by written one by one page. After complete your exam, you have to receive or capture photo from each of the page. Each of the page for sending information to your teacher. Clearly, you have to be capture your copy, capture your answer very clearly. You have to be see the answer is very clear or the photo is very clear. Then you copy all the photos. You can send your homework. You can send your homework in this space. This is the space. Follow clearly. Teacher write the marks. 50 points means 50 marks for this model test question. And against this question, you have to be send your answer by taking photo from your answer script. And then you can select all the copy pages, all the photo that is taken from your answer script, and look, here is a your work, at your work or attachment, add your work or attachment, your work or attachment, add attachment. You can add one by one or you can add as college photo. I just click the button add attachment, add attachment. And then you can see these drives. There is a different drives. One of them is Google Drives, link, file, pick photo, use camera, new docs, whatever you want you can upload. It is better to install pick photo very clearly one by one like that. I will show you now. Pick photo, I just click the word pick photo. Now there are different type of pick photo. Whatever you want you can select, such as I just select three photos for the as an answer sheet, as an answer script, as your answer copy, whatever you picked up. Now I select two my answer sheet. One of them is, as for example, page number 1. In this way, this page will be uploaded. and second attachment, add another page, then you can click the another photo like that. You can use one by one, you can add whatever you want. Whatever you want, in this way you can upload one by one. In this way, all the answer sheet, all the answer script, you can install in this way one by one. There is another option. There is another option by which you can, group your photo as PDF format. Look. Now you can send these activities, send your exam copy with the help of this way, hand in. Three attachments will be submitted. Hand in your work. You collected your homework. You collected your exam copy. Now you can submit. Three attachments. I just click hand in. In this way, your copy assigned, hand in, submitted, unsubmitted, or submitted, whatever you want. You can return back or you can submit. In this way, your teacher can receive your homework. Your teacher will receive your homework from this page. You just go to the people page and you can see whatever you name. You can see your homework, or teacher will see this homework, whatever you send to your teacher. Whatever you send to your teacher as homework from the, against this activities. These are the activities. You can unsubmit or you can submit. You can see, or teacher also can see your homework. No other can see these activities. In this way, you can upload your homework to your Google Classroom. Another way, you can select, you can transport, you can add your homework. There is another software. You just see Cam Scanner, CS. The software symbol represented at CS. This is the Cam Scanner. With the help of this Cam Scanner, you can scan or submit a as PDF format. As PDF format, you can submit or you can see everything. Use now. Allow. Now I am trying to see the photos, selected photos. I just select three photos, four photos, whatever. Or you can start scanning or select photo. I just select three photos. 1, 2, 3, 4. Whatever you want, you can select. Show selected. These are the selected photos. I can deselect all the photos or I can select all the photos. I can deselect or select all the photos. Then you just push the button done. Done. Done, and the recent is done. In this way, you can complete or transport all the activities as a as a PDF format. You just send your activities, create a new folder, you can prepare a folder, continue. As for example, exam one, as you can send all the copies, or you can receive all the copies, or you can send all the copies. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 3, 4. I just import in this way. You can call this or PDF, preview PDF, all the copies in a specific place. You can store in a specific place whatever you want. You can send to your classroom also. You can send your work to your classroom also as college form, as a specific form by which new attachment attached to assignment, select assignment, whatever the assignment is given the teacher, you can select. There is no assignment because of in this place there is a specific folder. With the help of this folder, you can share, or you can do, or you can receive everything whatever you want. You can set is in the Google Drive as another name, exam 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever you want you can write. I have 3 Google Drive. I just uploaded in this place, save here as exam 1. Save here. Now this Google Drive is complete, and I'll go back to the previous class and see the classrooms and the assignments. And in the lower portion of the assignment, here is written your work. Here is written your work. See your work. See your work in the lower part of the unsubmit. You can add more attachment from your drive, whatever you saved. My drive, from this my drive and classroom, plus boy classroom, whatever 3 model test questions are there, you can submit from this place. Or in this way, you can share drive. You can use another share drive, whatever you want. In this way, you can then send attach, hand, and submit. In this way, you can submit all the homework copy, all the exam script. In this way, you can submit to your teacher your homework and so on, whatever you write, whatever you done, everything. So viewers, I am trying to explain how to use Google Classroom as a student. You can use your classroom as a teacher also, such as create a class and then continue. Just check out the box and then the page is not okay, and then continue. In this way, you can select a classroom, you can select a classroom or a specific room or a specific room for the student. Class, the name of the class, trying to write the name of the class is class 8, section whatever, boys and girls, room whatever you can give, it is not important, and subject is very important, such as science. In this way you can create, just give a click on the create button. In this way your class room is created for the students, and student can enter this class, student can enter this class sorry for the inconvenience So in this way a class is naturally created, and in this way you can send your student a password like that, password class code 262S86N. In this way, in every class a new class easily generated. You can change this class code, you can change this class code, or you can rearrange this class code with the help of refresh or remove this class code. So students and viewers, I'm trying to explain how to use Google Classroom very easily, and how to upload file in Google Classroom, and how to create a class. It will be helpful to upload and serve in this situation. So best of luck. I hope you understand very easily. So see you next video. Till then, Allah Hafiz.